I am using my Papilio Pro as logic analyzer, and doing that is not very difficult if you follow the explanation in one of the Gadget Factory forum threads. There is a thread about porting logical analyzer from 1 to Pro, and this thread contains everything you need. It contains the project file, it contains the bit files, and it contains the specific constraint file for the Papilio Pro. So the big work here has been done by a number of people, and I started to get interested in this thread because I wanted to see what's possible there. And I've asked Magnus, who has been doing all the work here, if he could post his original project, because there was one issue with the bit file that was posted here, and that is that the inputs had pull-down enabled. And that's quite a heavy load if you're measuring a signal. So I've copied the project from Magnus. I have changed it so that the pull downs are gone. I uploaded two images here. One image with how it looks like with the pull down in place in the constraint file, and another image on how it looks like if those constraints are not there. And this is the effect. You can see here a bitmap that I've taken with the constraint file having the pulldowns on the input, and then a second image that I've taken with the pulldowns removed. When the pulldowns are removed, I get my 3.3 signal measured as approximately 3.2, 3.4. If I have the pull-downs in place, that signal is weakened to 2 volts to 20 volts, depending on the strength of the driving pin. This is a I2C signal that I've used from a real circuit. So what I've done now is I have uploaded to that same thread a bit file where the pull-downs are disabled, and I've uploaded the constraint file that I've used, and it's working quite well. I'll now show how it looks like in the project navigator from Xilinc. So you import Magnus's project, you replace his papiliopro.ucf file with mine, and you'll see that for the input pins, for all the input pins, I have removed this part, the pull-down part. So this is how my constraint file looks like. This is how the constraint file originally looked like. So this makes the big difference. Once you've done that, you save everything. You implement the top module. You click on Generate Programming File, click right, say Run. And once that's done, you can upload that bit file to your Papilio Pro, and you're good to go to run it with the OpenLogic Sniffer client that's available on the internet. All works very well, and you have a decent 30-bit logic analyzer as part of your Papilio Pro toolset.
And this is the result. You get the Papilio Pro with the famous flashing logic sniffer LED. This side here is your first 16 channels, and connector C is your second 16 channels, so you have 32 logic inputs for your analyzer.